is Prakash of the BJP, senior BJP leader from Karnataka, joining us on phone line. Pooja, requesting you also to stay with us on the story. Mr. Prakash, first reaction on this extremely provocative and unwarranted remark by Congress leader.
The government first immediately arrest Mr. Jayachandra for inciting violence against the Prime Minister himself. His language is unacceptable. These days, congressmen crossing all the limits. Each one of them is calling him mosquito, dengue, Scorpio. Now, Jayachandra has set a new benchmark. He wants the Prime Minister burnt alive. This is terribly tragic, and he should be arrested by the government for attempting to murder the Prime Minister.
Sir, is the BJP party mulling over filing a complaint over this, taking a legal action, thinking of taking a legal action against the leader, against Jayachandran?
Definitely, the BJP will take up with the government and also with the DGP. That apart, it is the duty, police are duty bound to arrest him. Because nobody should speak in that language to the Prime Minister of the nation. He's not a Prime Minister of BJP. He's a Prime Minister of everyone in the country. How can he make such derogatory, abusive, inciting language? There is a law and order in Karnataka. There is a...
All right. Class.
Hello?
But... overall, how do you look at this? There is a pattern to this abuses and such provocative remarks coming from Congress leaders across the nation. There's a pattern to it. Why do you think Congress is doing this? All right, we'll try and get you more political reactions on this, but Akshita Nandgopal of Republic TV confronted TB Jayachandra on his outrageous comment. We spoke to him on phone, and this is what he has to say.
Sir, this is Akshita Nandgopal speaking from Republic TV. Sir, I just wanted your comment with regards to a remark that we've got, a video of you, sir, saying that we should burn Mr. Modi alive for what happened with demonetization.
No. It is the statement of Narendra Modi spelled out that Panji only. It has been reported. Okay. I sent a copy to, forwarded the Modi statement also.
No, sir. So we've got the full context. No, we've got the full context, sir. We've got the full context. We have the entire video where you're saying that Modi said this, but you're still endorsing it, aren't you, sir, by saying that, yes, it is time to set him on fire.
No. He has said that he should be burnt alive. He has volunteered to burnt alive.
You are endorsing it, aren't you, sir? Aren't you endorsing and saying, isn't it time?
No. It is for him. It is for him to decide whether to remain in office or not.
No, sir. So the Prime Minister, I agree. The Prime Minister said it and you quoted him. No one is, saying no to that. But the fact is that you endorsed it, didn't you, sir? And you can't deny that. We have the statement with us. You endorsed it saying that it is time for Modi to be burnt alive.
No, but it is his statement. Burnt alive means not, we are not burning it. It is for him to decide.
But sir, you are saying it is time. You are saying it is time
No, it is not burning him. It is his own statement.
Sir, you got... So you made the statement. You are saying that it's attributed only to the Prime Minister. The BJP has now come out and asked questions. They are saying that this kind of a statement deserves a public apology. Are you willing to apologize, sir?
No. I'm repeating again and again. It is a statement of Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of India.
He's the Prime Minister,
He has asked for only 50 days.
Sir, if he is the Prime Minister and you've made this statement where you're saying it's time to make Prime Minister Narendra Modi on fire
alive. I'm just reminding.
If he is the Prime Minister and you're making the statement, sir, you said time to say, let me remind him of the statement,
please,
sir.
Please correct me.
On this,
I'm just reminding the Prime Minister. Statement made by him.
But sir, in your statement, did you say, let me remind him of his statement, or did you say it is time to set him on fire?
No, I am reminding him of his own statement.
Okay, sir, if there are sentiments that are hurt, and clearly there are, many people have been objecting to this statement. The BJP is also saying that they may take legal action. They are demanding an apology. Will you apologize?
No. I am just reminding. I'm just reminding the Prime Minister the statement made by him only.
But sir, will you apologize? If people's sentiments are hurt, it is for a reason. Because
it is not. It is his own statement.
But if sentiments are hurt, are you willing to apologize?
No, it's his own statement. I'm just reminding him.
Sir, if you look at exactly what you've said, you have said the day has come where we must burn Modi alive. You are saying the time has come to burn Modi alive.
You have to read it like this. I've just reminded Narendra Modi ji of his statement.
What you've said, sir.
We will not do it.
You have said it differently,
but
so I'm asking you to apologize. Are you willing to apologize?
We are just reminding. We are just reminding the statement of Narendra Modi ji.
But sir, I am going to repeat the words you said. The day has come where we must burn Modi alive. That is not a reminder, sir. You are saying it is time to burn him alive.
My intention is not that. My intention is that people should know what you have said.
So you are saying you will not apologize for the statement, right, sir? You are saying you will not apologize.
No. I am telling you repeatedly. I am just reminding his own statement.
Okay, but the BJP is demanding an apology. What is your response to that?
No. Please let them read the statement of Narendra Modi ji.
Okay. Mr. Jayachandra, thank you so much for speaking to us. Thank you, sir.
So TB Jayachandra there refusing to apologize and also attempting to cover up this outrageous statement. In fact, we have Tanveer Ahmed, national spokesperson JDS, joining us on phone line. Tanveer, your first reaction. Are you not going to strongly object and condemn such an outrageous statement? And not only that, ask your coalition partner to pull up the Neta concerned here?
Actually, we are reading too much between the lines. Mr. Narendra Modi had said, if at all I don't solve the problem within 50 days, please burn me anywhere.
Tanveer, shall we play out that entire sequence again for you?
From last 2 years,
don't misinterpret or put.
Killed the economy of this country.
Don't try to tweak it for your convenience.
The economy has
let's hear it once again, Tanveer Ahmed.
No, you can play the
Tanveer Ahmed, it's not about demonetization or economy. It seems to be fashionable for certain parties to constantly abuse and rank choices of abuses for the Prime Minister of the country.
No,
your coalition partner, hold on, Tanveer. Can we play that reaction again? So why are you not pulling him up? You're neither pulling him up either.
No, we don't need
he
to.
He says, burn the Prime Minister alive. It's time to burn the PM alive.
No, it's not about burning alive.
So do you, whether it is reminding or whether it is in a different context, Tanveer Ahmed? Is JDS on a back foot on this? Are you not going to ask Congress to apologize or pull up the Neta, pull up the former law minister of Karnataka?
Mr. TB Jayachandra is a very, very learned man with very, very big dignity. I think what he was talking not about burning. It was talking about people who have pulled the economy down. They need to really answer the question.
And in that context, Mr. Tanveer Ahmed, he has named none other than the Prime Minister. He is saying Prime Minister Modi. So if you're calling him learned, he should be learned enough to come forward and apologize. Thank you very much, meanwhile, Tanveer Ahmed, for that reaction on the story. Thank you.